Probably helped to have my mic on. Well, welcome everyone to tonight's game between the Raiders and the Patriots. I am Miguel Devanter. Along with me is Alex Savia Heaney.
Hello.
And
I was waiting for you to start.
Yeah, I was chatting away and I didn't have my mic on because, you know, I'm special today. I see the Raiders are lined up taking the field, so I can only assume there the Patriots are coming in. And this is the first game of season two for the CFL. What are your thoughts about this game tonight, Alex?
Well, I'm pretty excited. It's being season two. Hopefully, from last year, the Patriots have learned a little something, and they're coming out here tonight strong against the Raiders.
Well, the Patriots still do have their share of veterans. Quite a few names I've seen from first season of me commentating many years ago. But the Raiders, I know, are very strong. I know I've faced them before in scrims leading up to this game, and they're a pretty solid team.
Well, then this should be a good matchup tonight.
I think so. So I hope you guys are ready for this game, and thank you for tuning in or purchasing a ticket. If you had. Let me get these ads up. I don't know.
What was that?
I was just getting a note card for the.
Oh.
Oh, man. I totally cannot hear the field because I have to hear you. So. Don't know what's going on down there, but I'm guessing they're just getting ready for the coin toss. And all that, we have Al Panuka, Ahmad Heckroth, and of course, Trayon Bilkin, referees tonight. Let's see. Okay. So we have a DJ tonight too, don't we? That I heard.
We do.
Yeah, what's up with that? I didn't have a. Oh, okay. I'm being told I'm being recorded. So I gotta watch my language. Apparently they know me too well.
This is G rated. Or PG.
It's PG? G? I don't know. I'll wash my mouth out before kickoff.
This is PG-13.
That's all right. So what's up with the DJ tonight? Is the guy actually playing music, or is it just like? I don't know what to do.
Yeah,
right, you tell me.
There's music going on the stream right now.
I don't know much of the operations of the CFL. I just know how it used to be run, but that was years ago. Yeah. So.
We do have a DJ, and he is playing music.
Cool, cool. And of course, join us at halftime where we have the lovely ladies performing. What are the names? I forget.
Being a former cheerleader, that'll be interesting to see.
Yeah, do you like watching other teams perform or no?
I bet you do.
Well, I know I do, but I mean, do you? Have you ever, like, found yourself, like, kicking yourself for another team having thought of something first?
Sometimes, but for the most part, it was always, something from another team, and someone else would just take it, so.
And
but I heard
there's
a
cheering.
New HUD out.
Oh, yeah, there's one. I saw it. It makes it, like, ridiculously easy. You could just have a bunch of alts out there, and they just sit on the thing, and one person does it for everybody.
Isn't that what a dance hood does, Miguel?
No, because before they used to actually have to move in their position. This new thing I saw was like, they sit in there and it moves the formation for them.
Oh, so.
So it's like one person doing all the work, basically.
Huh.
But, you know, they always look good anyway. Oh, I'm being told only the Patriot Divas are performing. The Raiders are taking a page out of the NFL Packers, who don't have a cheerleader in real life. So.
That makes me want to consider cheering again this season a little more.
Did you see who won? Oh, they're doing the coin toss right now. Okay, good. So we go first coin toss of the season. I don't know, heads came up. I don't know what that means. I don't know who called what. I thought this field told you when who called who won. I guess not.
You have to guess.
I have to. I can't guess. I think the common practice is whoever wins is going to kick off anyways to receive the second half.
Probably.
But it looks like the Patriots are lining up for the kickoff, so my guess is they won.
Good guess.
Hey, all right. So what do we have kicking for them? I think it's Razdan? No, Lassane. By the way, I'm only reading resident names. I don't read. What's the other name? Display names. I don't read that. So, my apologies. Like, I don't know if I should turn them on. I guess I will turn them on. Display names and username. There we go. So now I'll be able to see everything. Wow, I totally can't read that. Okay, whatever. The St. Crux 88, number 88 for the Patriots, will be kicking off. A little bit of confusion there. I think they got an extra man on the field right now.
Oh, look, it did tell you who won the coin toss.
Did it?
Yeah.
Ah, see? Just a little lag. See? Told you the Patriots did. Whoa. Wow, I think we're a little delayed on the start here. Something's up with the... Actually, both teams seem to be missing a couple people or having some personnel issues, I guess.
This is expected to happen the first game of the season.
Yeah, but I have run a lot of scrims, and the games do go by a lot quicker. And of course, I watched a lot of games last season, and they go by a lot quicker than previous leagues. So hopefully it's not like my first day's commentating where I'd be here 4 hours talking to myself. That was annoying.
Yeah, that can get hard.
But you've commentated before, right?
I have for the CFL. I commentated the preseason last year. However, I did not commentate after that.
Oh, so they didn't ask you to come back.
No.
I guess they're giving you a second chance finally. Maybe they forgot how terrible you were or something.
Yeah, pretty much.
Just kidding.
I was needed in other places.
All right, so Raiders still looking like they need one person back there in the back corner. The Patriots here are tagging in and out. I'm not sure what's going on there. Wow. Alright, so while this is going on, let's take care of that first ad for tonight.
Alrighty. Come over to Cap Z, located on the field of the CFL Seahawks. Cover up that bald spot with style at a hat store for everyone. Not just sporting hats, no lids, just caps. We have an array of NFL, CFL, and custom caps. Want to support your CFL team or get a funny cap? With Cap Z, hit up Cameron Cora or Troy Bier for your custom order.
There you go. Cap Z, your first sponsor for tonight's game. Season opener here.
Someone who was just looking for a hat earlier.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I don't generally wear hats. But maybe I should get one, you know, support my team.
I think that's a decent
idea. So here we go. Ball is in play. We do have the same kicking off for the Patriots. Nice kick there. Picked up by Action Jackson. He's out on the right side there to the 40 and brought down by the kicker, Lassane himself. So not a bad pickup there, 25 yards to set up the first drive here. And we have the Raiders lining up in the shotgun formation. Marcus Jacks under center. We got Action Jackson and Andre Hunter on the near side. Gooch Prada and Malik Lipton on the far side. And Valentino Fallon as running back. But as Action Jackson takes a snap, he runs out to the far side. Sneaks past a couple guys, almost crosses the line of scrimmage, but doesn't. He's looking deep down, and he has wide open Gooch Prada. Easy catch. No one there to contend with him. All the way in for a touchdown. So what a great opening play there. 61-yard pass.
Wow.
That's one hell of a way to start the season, I think. Terrell Fenrisson now lined up for the extra point attempt. So what are your thoughts on that there?
Where was the blocking for the Patriots and where was the defense for the Patriots? Obviously non-existent in that play.
Yeah. Gooch was out there, I mean, wide open out the sidelines. No one near him. I mean, when
if
you
they
exploit
keep that
this.
Up,
yeah.
They have no chance.
I don't know if that was just a blown assignment, because your secondary does not keep up with those deep routes. You're gonna be torn to shreds, especially in this league, from what I've seen. So the Raiders lined up for extra point. There it goes, and it is good. So 7-0 Patriots, and only 28 seconds taken off the clock.
So the Raiders,
first,
the
Raiders. I did say they're done. Oh, I'm getting confused already.
You did say the Patriots.
Not bad. So 7-0 Raiders over the Patriots. And the Raiders lined up to kick. So real quick, just one play, and I already got a touchdown. I don't know if you've watched many scrims, Alex, but the passing has definitely gotten a lot better than years before.
I've only had the chance actually to watch one scrimmage.
And here comes the kickoff to the Patriots. Picked up in the end zone by Lassane. It's going up the numbers there, but brought down at the 20-yard line. So let's see what the Patriots do here to answer. And they're lining up in the shotgun formation. Razdan under center, Pit Dog at running back. We have Lassane and Carter Alchemy the far side. Mike Money and Diablo Dark Matter on the near side. Some of the Raiders, they're pressing forward a little bit. I'm not sure if they're looking to blitz. There's a snap. Razdan runs back. He's got a couple guys in his face, and he throws it away almost. I don't know if he was actually aiming for someone. My Money Mike was closest to that. But he had a lot of pressure coming in. So I guess there was a little bit of a blitz there. I know the Patriots have been looking for linemen. They do seem fully staffed here, so I'm not sure if there's just a little more work needs to be done, or maybe they're just not used to.
I don't understand why blitz. Carter is not QBing.
I'm not sure either, but there obviously is a reason for that. Let's see if we can get a hold of Razin later and ask him after the game. All right, the clock has been paused temporarily. I don't know if there's some issue with personnel here. Or...
we'll have an after-game interview.
That'd be kind of cool if we can do that. And Trey Bilkin is out there on the field. I'm not sure what's happening there. I know Carter Alchemy's off his ball, so is Bunny Mike, so...
maybe the hair does?
Not sure. I guess they're changing the formation? Or resetting the formation?
That'd be kind of interesting if they did, and Kyle's not a QB.
My guess is one of them just couldn't see the little pyramid you sit on. Alright, so there we go. Ball is in play. Lineup the same, so here comes Razin taking the snaps, rolls out to the far side, throws it down there. He's got Lassan down there, double covered. But wow, Lassan did manage to pick that up with two guys on him down to the 48-yard line of the Raiders. So a nice 32-yard pass there.
That was a very good play. Now let's see if they can keep that up.
They're lined up at the shotgun formation again. Two running backs this time, Money Mike and Pit Dog. Carter Alchemy and the Saint still at the far side, and Diablo Dark Matter on the near side. But still, we're seeing now both teams are going to the air early. And there's a snap. Handoff to Money Mike, who gets brought down behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of 5 yards.
Well, I think being the first game of the season, every team for their first game has something that they want to prove.
No, it's true. It's true. And but certainly it has been a lot more. The aerial threats have been a lot better. I know passing and catching has improved across the league.
So. That's a huge plus.
That's good. It makes it a lot more exciting. We got 6:40 left on the clock, so the clock is still ticking down. 20 seconds left on the play clock. Let's see how Razin does here on 2nd and 15 from their own 47-yard line. There's a snap. He runs out. It hands it off to Pit Dog. Pit Dog's on the far side, and nope, cannot get past that as Torolf is there to tackle him. Another loss. Another loss for the Patriots.
So the Raiders. Not looking too good for them.
Well, the Raiders are handling the running game very well. They're doing a good job of stopping them so far. I think now, 3rd and 17, Ryzen's going to have to look to the air. Going to have to look downfield, get someone open. But it seems like the Raiders are still looking to rush in. And Valentino and Torolf, they're pressing up. I guess they want a piece of the quarterback there. There's a snap. Hand off to Pit Dog, who runs it out. Looking downfield. Crossfield pass. Whole bunch of people there, but intercepted by Grooch Prada, and he's immediately brought down by the Saints. So very great defensive stand there by the Raiders.
You weren't kidding when you said the Raiders were a really good, solid team.
No, they're good. I mean, I've played against them quite a few times leading up to the season, so those are scrims, but you know, you still get to see a little bit of that talent. Here you go in the shotgun formation. Marcus Jack snaps the ball. A little bit of confusion on the field. Not sure what's going on. Maybe an inadvertent snap. A little too early.
No cadence.
No cadence was the call there. So a 5-yard penalty. It says to the Raiders after that great interception. Which puts them back to, what is it, 22-yard line?
First down.
I don't see the field moving back. Or the, Line of scrimmage has not moved back yet. There it goes. So it's about the 23-yard line for the Raiders. So maybe you know, because I keep seeing players wearing non-traditional helmets out there. What's up with that?
I have no idea.
I guess it's allowed now. Marcus Jackson,
maybe
number 24
that's
for the Raiders.
You can ask in your interview.
I think I will if we can get someone up here. So Marcus Jackson, under center, takes a snap, runs out to his right. Oh, finds an opening, and he goes down, straight down the field. He's got a couple of blockers over the pick him up. He's got the first down. Nice little spin move there, midfield, and is finally, he's bumped and brought down at the 50-yard line there.
Wow.
By Aaron Dufour, or what's his name, Money Mike now? So great run by Marcus Jacks, showing us all that the Raiders can, you know, do more than just pass.
It seems as though the Patriots so far, they're having a heck of a time trying to stop them.
You just had to tie it up on defense. I don't know if, not sure if it's just blown coverages or whatnot, but there was a huge hole that opened up for Marcus in that last play, right around the hash, and just allowed him to run through. Here he takes a snap. He's running down to his right. He's got Pit Dog almost closing in on him, but a couple blockers in his face. Nice deep throw down there. He's got Stoop. Who was that? Malik Lipton bringing down the catch. And immediately tackled by Diablo Dark Matter. So a great 36-yard pass there, which brings them into Patriots territory, deep into Patriots territory on their 13-yard line. They go lining up again, the shotgun formation. Action Jackson, Andre Hunter on the left. On the right, excuse me, Malik and Gooch Prada on the right. Valentino Fallon running back again. Another pause in the play clock. 3:46 left in this half. Ball is back in play. There's a snap. Marcus Jackson runs it out to the left, finds a nice big gaping hole, and slips right in 13 yards for the touchdown. Marcus Jackson just showing how talented he is on his feet. Finding that hole and just taking advantage of it, slipping right in.
Patriots are going to have to find some way to stop them.
Well, an answer back. I mean, there was a... This is, of course, you know, it's another 6 points right now, almost seven. If he makes his kick off a turnover. And it was a great pass. He had plenty of people before, you know, but just happened to be picked off, excuse me.
You okay?
Yeah, I might need a little bit of water, but I should be all right. And the kick is up and good. So the Raiders 14, Patriots 0, 3:38 left in this first quarter. Excuse me. So here we go, lining up for the kickoff again. How about
Patriots can fire back with a touchdown?
Yeah, they are getting in position there. Toroff again lined up to kick this off. So I guess it is all right for players to wear extracurricular stuff. I don't know if I should call it that. Oh, I'm sorry. Was there like a line change there? I think I missed the line change. No. All right, so ball is in play now. Let's see how they're doing this kickoff. Return, nice deep kick. Pit Dog fields it just inside in the end zone. He's off, he's at about the 20-yard line and flying up the hash, but has swarmed immediately by the Raiders at about the 25-yard line. Oh, so let's see how the Patriots answer this here. Again, the shotgun formation. I know it's a very popular formation in the league. Most people seem to
stick with it. I think just about everybody uses that formation.
Yeah, it's, you know. You get a good separation there from the line. Well, maybe it's broke, it still be fixed. Or if it's not broke, it still be fixed. Oh, we got Diablo Dark Matter Money, Mike. On the near side, Carter Alchemy and Lissay on the far. And Pit Dog running back next to Razdin under center. There's a snap. Razdin takes it back, rolls out to the left. He's got Valentino Fallon,
wow,
who was right there to sack him for a loss of 10 yards. Almost 11.
He has nobody right face, now blocking for him.
Well, Valentino came in off that outside linebacker position, and his line just did not move with him. So the Patriots' offensive line needs a little bit of work. At the very least, drop back just a little bit. Don't get caught up immediately, and just try to protect your quarterback wherever he's running to. There you go. It's taking them a little bit of time to get in. We got 2:30 left on the clock. It is ticking down. 5 seconds left on the play clock. There's a snap. Razdin rolls out right. It's out in the end zone. Bumped, but he manages to get the ball off. He's got Lassane Cook out there who catches the ball at about the 45-yard line, and he's heading all the way down to the end zone. The 20, the 10, he is clear right into the end zone. So great 86-yard touchdown play there by the Patriots.
That
to put them on the board.
Impressive.
It was great. I mean, I thought Razdin was going to be brought down there in the end zone for safety, but he managed to slip past the blitzers and then got the ball off just in time. And
as
right on the mark.
I was getting
beautiful
worried.
Play by the Patriots. Beautiful play by the Patriots there to answer back. Here you go. They line up for the extra kick. The extra point, excuse me. So how about we get another? Let's get some more information on some of our sponsors here. Another one. Oh, kick
need
us up.
Need to surprise your friend with a res day gift? Need something extra to make your proposal extra special? Or are you opening your own club or mall? Maybe you just want to entertain and have some fun. Then why not hire the It Girls and Fellas, a professional dance troupe that always has fresh ideas for that perfect moment, and regular off-Broadway shows at our beautiful theater in Second Life. Contact Winsong Charming for details.
There you go, the It Girls and Fellas. They show up to parties, huh?
Okay. That'd be kind of interesting.
Have parties, hire a bunch of people to show up.
To go see one of those Broadway shows.
That'd be neat. I actually did work for another dance troupe years ago. This building
so
stage
did
is
I.
Fun. Oh, cool. Look at that.
Last season.
No, this was a long, long, long time ago. Okay, and I don't know what's going up here. The same there, taking up that kicker's position. Seems to be a little bit of an issue. With the formations. They did stop the play clock again. 2:07 left in this first quarter. I mean, amazing first quarter. 14-7. Whoa. My camera went a little weird there. I don't know what happened. I was trying to get in on the scoreboard. Oh, there you go. Vonnie L receives the kick, and I am not focused on the field. My camera went all over the place. I don't know what the hell's going on here. I clicked on an errant something or other. And hopefully it'll fix itself, I hope. But Aaron did get to pick up, or Money Mike as he is now known, did get to pick up 30 yards for first down. The 27-yard line for the Raiders. Yeah, I'm not, I don't know what's going on with my... Some very,
aggressive fans.
Enthusiastic fans out there. Wow. Let's see if pass was incomplete. I apologize, guys. My camera's not falling onto the field. I am, like, stuck somewhere. And I does not want to move. All right, did it fix itself? Or no? Or no? Nah. There we go. Wow. Okay. My apologies for that. So the Raiders back in the shotgun face. Back in the shotgun formation. Marcus Jacks takes it out to the right. He's got a couple blockers, left, a couple blockers running with him. He decides to run it up himself, burns his own blockers, but has a great opening there. Manages to run 24 yards to the 51-yard line. A great run there by Marcus Jacks. I'm not sure if he was looking downfield, did not find a receiver, and just took it himself. Or if that was a design play. Either way, great pickup.
So what I'm finding really interesting is I'm not remembering some of these names on the Raiders. And if they're rookies this season, they've practiced quite a bit.
So Marcus Jacks there just brought down for a loss. 7-yard loss back to the 44-yard line. There's a few that have been around for a while.
But, I know a few names, but like Marcus, I've never heard of him.
I can't say I remember calling his name before when I commentated. So here goes Marcus Jacks taking the snap, rolling out to the left. Set a couple guys downfield, but decides to run it himself again down the left side, which they've been exploiting so far all night. He weaves through a few defenders, picks up the first down. 19 yards. First and 10.
He was gone for a second there.
He looked like he almost was. It's, the Raiders are just picking apart that the far side there. Here's Marcus Jacks running down to the right this time. He's got one guy coming in. Switches down midfield. And he's got one guy wide open in the end zone, but overthrows him. That was Malik, I believe. No, that's the other guy with the horned helmet. Action Jackson. Action was wide open at the end zone, but just a little past him. So we're seeing the Raiders definitely exploiting the secondary for the Patriots. Patriots' safeties have to pull in a little tighter there. And it looks like someone is not in for the Patriots. I think they have Crip Englewood coming in. Yep. Crip Englewood coming in, taking that far side linebacker position. And it is the start of the second half. Oh, excuse me. Second quarter. We would have missed the cheerleaders. That would have sucked. Start of the second quarter. There's the snap.
We don't want you missing cheerleaders.
No, definitely not. A handoff to Vonnie Valentino, who runs up that left side. They've been just tearing through all night, picking up the first down. Another 17-yard pickup. It's a first and 10 here for the Raiders. 8:30 left, so plenty of football still. Well, the Patriots definitely have to do a little bit of work. Tighten this up. I think we got an extra man on the field. He's running out now. And there's a snap. He's running out to the right. No pressure on him. wide open receiver out there. Action Jackson didn't need to do much adjusting there to pick up that pass. So quick strike there. 20-yard touchdown play. 20-7 Raiders over the Patriots. It's a pretty fast pace open season opener.
Perhaps at halftime, Raston will switch up his positions a little bit better.
Well, I'm sure he'll give him a...
Because this right now is not working for the Patriots.
No, definitely is not. They didn't even seem to be ready there defensively. But the extra point is good for the Raiders, 21-7. What about another, any information on another sponsor while we set up for the kick?
Check out Southern California, a theme sim dedicated to real-life SoCal beaches. Come relax on the beach, feed some seagulls, take a bike ride along the coast, and soak up some sun with friends. Complete with our tropical SoCal swap meet area. Gotcha yacht sales. And the famous Southern Cal sport skateboarding at our local skate park. Stores located in the town's main area for all your shopping needs, including clothing for dudes with a California feel. Lots of photography opportunities with a realistic... Oh, never mind. That's a different one.
Is it? I'm not sure.
Yeah, I believe it is. Yes, it is. There was no space in between them.
No space. Editing. It's good for you. So, the kickoff resulted in a touchback, so the Patriots are going to have it on their own 20-yard line. Here they are in the two running back shotgun formation. Diablo Darkman on the near side, Carter Alchemy, and Crip Englewood on the far side. Money Mike and Pit Dog as the running backs. There's a snap, a handoff to Pit Dog. Doesn't have, had a huge hole actually. Didn't have any defenders there. Manages to get 5 yards. So second and five on the 25-yard line. 7:45 left.
Year, yeah. He was not. He was very good for the Patriots.
Pit Dog?
Yes.
Yeah, he definitely has some talent. I played with him on another team before. Excuse me. So Razin under center. Again, same formation. I think they like this two running back. And there's a snap and a handoff to Money Mike, who does not have the hole that that Pit Dog did, and is brought down at the 22-yard line, so a loss of four there. Three, four, yeah. So third and nine for the Patriots here. And I have a feeling Razin's going to look to air this one out.
He's going to have to do something to get that first down.
No, he definitely will have to. I think he'll be seeing him pass out to Carter, most likely. Play clock running down, 16 seconds. There's a snap. Razin's rolling out, dropping back pretty far, looking for Diablo Dark Matter, who does manage to catch the ball. Two defenders on him, and he manages to pull it down to the Raiders' 43-yard line. So great pass there.
That was a huge catch. Well,
it was definitely needed. Definitely needed to get them out at the third and long hole that they got themselves in. Here we go, they're sticking with the same formation. But you notice that Diablo caught the ball, immediately brought down because of the two guys on him. That's one thing that the Patriots are going to have to do when they're defending, to keep those yards after the catch down. So 5:33 left on the clock for this half. 10 seconds on the play clock. It's going to have to get this ball off soon. Two, and there he goes. There's a snap. He drops back, straight back. rolling a little bit to his right, looking in the middle there, but intercepted by Marcus Jacks, who's running down the field, down to the 40-30. Razin's the last guy left there. He cuts right past him. A couple guys still on him. He's still got some defenders. He hands the ball off to Torolf, who was, I don't think he realized the ball was handed off to him. He kind of just stood there. But it brought down finally at the 10-yard line. So great defensive play by the Raiders. Huge defensive play.
I'm not quite sure what it is exactly that the Patriots are lacking so far, but I do not remember them being like this last season.
I am not sure. I mean, some of those names have been around for a long time, so I'm not sure if they're just not ready for it today, a little nervous maybe. And the referee has called a timeout. I'm not sure if are they reviewing plays this season? I actually don't know if they are or not. But it's late. Oh, I guess they didn't call the time. They didn't stop their play call? I'm not sure there. But so we have the referees calling timeout for some reason. Let's see if we can get some information on that. In the meantime, let's hear, what was that one that was... Was it? What are, no,
experience
it was it.
The unique atmosphere of the Mystic Rose Club. With stunning design and decor, the club is open to all. Listen to music and dance on the state-of-the-art dance floor. For romantic moments, retreat with your partner to the secluded tables on the second floor or visit the bar. Weekend events start off with a live DJ and to set the mood and followed by live singers to close out the evening.
Nice. Have you been to the Mr. Gross Club?
That's a nice date night.
Yeah.
Or a double date night.
A double date night. Watch out, people are listening. So don't want to give them any ideas.
I said double date, that means four people.
I know, but I'm gonna have them in my IM soon. Anyways, I guess we're still waiting to hear from the referees, seeing what's going on here.
Well, I'm gonna do another sponsor.
To do another one? We do have quite a bit of sponsors, thankfully, this season.
Yes. Virtual Attitude Wrestling is the number one virtual-based organization grid-wide, representing two weekly shows, Elite Tuesdays at 5 p.m. SLT, Turbulence Thursdays at 3 p.m. SLT. Be sure to come down with your family and friends and be a part of the magic of Second Life. Check it's out not- our website here.
Did they give you the website? No.
Just going to shout it.
Just, oh, okay. I was going to say just search.
Just
search. See, now that sounds a better date night. I mean, I'm just saying. Or, you know, the next football game.
Oh, God, I whispered. Oops.
Yeah, okay, so only I hear it? That's great. Actually, we have a few people up here in the booth with us.
Okay, there we go.
Everyone's sitting on the table. I don't think they're supposed to, but whatever. And I hope you guys out there are enjoying this game so far. But we still have a referee timeout going on. I'm not sure what they're discussing.
Okay, well, let's do another sponsor.
We can probably hold on.
With four radio what? Stations to choose... What radio? What? With four radio stations to choose from. Hip-hop, R&B, Soul Island, Reggae, Calypso, and Gospel.
What?
What?
Sorry, that reminds me of that one song, which I can't say.
You can. That's PG.
What?
Yeah.
Okay. The rest of it, I can't.
Yes, you can. That's definitely PG.
Not the song I was thinking. See? No, it's not. I told you. You can't say that. Anyways, go to YouTube. Just type what, and you'll see what I'm talking about.
I know
this. I know. I still. Well, I wish we had a little more information on what's going on, why the referees are kind of standing there, and what they're talking about the last episode of True Blood, how shitty that was. I mean, how crappy that was. Wow, is there a 7-second button? Whoops.
Oh, that's bound to happen.
Yeah, being handed some duct tape. I should have washed my mouth with soap. I don't know what's going on here. Now we got some of the players going over to the referees. Let me see if I can listen in down there. What are the people? Let's play a voice chat.
Wow.
Apply. No, I'm not hearing anything. Okay, I didn't hear anything out there, so I'm not sure what's happening. They're probably just talking in IMs.
Maybe they're just silent.
We got a couple players. Ronnie's running. I'm thoroughly confused. I'm not sure what is happening.
Okay, well.
Let's not repeat what we had before. we're going to run out of sponsors if we keep doing it.
No, we're definitely not.
You think second half will be a little faster?
I'm not sure.
Oh, go for it, I guess. Getting
Divalicious Designs. Come to the next game in style. Divalicious Designs has a vast selection of stunning clothing, skins, and hair for the ladies to get you looking your best. Don't worry, we didn't forget you guys. We have another shop for clothing devoted to the latest in men's fashion. Stop by and visit us today.
Wow, someone who did not forget penalty. The guys. Great.
Away team.
Very few. Whoa, 10-yard penalty. I don't even know what's going on here now.
Wow.
The away team is assessing. The Raiders were assessed a penalty, a 10-yard penalty.
Down.
I'm not sure what that penalty is. Assuming that's what they were discussing.
Let's see if that affects them at all.
I don't know. But there they go, lined up in the same shotgun formation. Marcus Jackson under center. Valentino Fallen is running back. Jackson and Andre Hunter on the near side. Malik and Gooch still on the far side. Maybe hopefully we'll get some clarification on what that penalty was, but there's a snap, a handoff to Valentino Fallen, who runs it up the left side there, trying to see if he could exploit it the same way the Pages have been doing it to them, and he does manage to pick up 4 yards before he's brought down by Crip Englewood. And they line up immediately. 4:37, 4:36 left on the clock. But still a little bit of time. But the Raiders, I don't know if they're looking to slow it down. They are ahead quite a bit here. There's a snap. Marcus Jacks started going right. Circled back to go down the middle, but took a little too long and brought down by Money Mike for a 3-yard loss after that 4-yard gain. So 3rd and 19 here for the Raiders. Not a position we've really seen them in tonight yet.
But it seems as though whatever reason that penalty was is starting to almost hurt them a little bit.
The Patriots seem to be a little tighter there. with their defense. They're able to close in quickly and prevent them from exploiting anymore. And there's a snap. He's going back, looking to the right. Has some receivers down there, and Action Jackson does grab it. That was a rather easy catch for him.
And I spoke too soon.
Exactly. 27-7 as we line up here for the point after attempt. To Rolf Fenrisson to kick. So yeah, I don't know. Usually when you get so close to the end zone, it's probably a little better to fall back a little. It gives you a little more room to work your receivers around. And there's a kick, and it is good. So 28-7 Raiders over the Patriots. Wow, 3:29 left in the half. Plenty of football left, guys. So we do want to thank you guys for joining us, whether you're watching on the stream, here at the stadium, or I hear it's being recorded, so I'm guessing it'll be shown at some point. We line up for the kickoff. We got Pit Dog, Lassane, and Diablo to receive. It's going out towards Diablo. Lassane does pick it up in the end zone. He's out to about the 20 right now. He's looking for a little more room. Doesn't seem to make it. It's brought down at the 19-yard line. So let's see what the Patriots can do here. From their own 19. And they do have to come up with some sort of answer here. I mean, 28-7. It's a little bit of a deficit, but it's not out of reach just yet. 3:18 left on the clock, 30 seconds on the play clock. Brasden still under center. Crip and Lassane on the far side, Ahmed and Money Mike on the near side. Pit Dog at running back. So you don't see Carter Alchemy on the field. Not sure what's going on there. There's a handoff to Pit Dog. Was immediately brought down as Terrell Fenrisson just came in. No one stopping him.
If Carter comes back, I really think Rasson needs to give him a shot at quarterback.
Well, let's see. I don't know. Is he on the sidelines? I didn't check. I'm actually not seeing him on the sideline. That could be why Razin is quarterback. Perhaps he not
he
able
crashed.
To play this. Crashford is not able to play.
He was here.
Okay. Yeah, I did see him. We'll see. 2:30. Clock is still winding down. 10 seconds left on the play clock. 2:23 left in the half. 4:03. Let's get that ball snap. There he goes. A handoff. Quick handoff. To Pit Dog, but again, brought down rather quickly. Another loss. So 3rd and 17 now for the Patriots in their 12-yard line. 2-minute warning, so clock does luckily stop for them. For the Patriots, gives them a little more time. Hopefully they can devise some sort of play here.
It seems like you would almost think that the Raiders just know what the Patriots are going to do.
Well, the Raiders are definitely putting a lot more pressure and looking to get through, and they're succeeding in getting past them. If the Patriots look to other formations that, you know, probably bring in some of the wide receivers in to help block at least a little bit. And there's Razden with a snap, dropping back, almost brought down. And, I think there's a little bit of pass interference out there. There's a little bit of pass interference. The Raiders.
The play is under review.
I think it was Lassane. Looked like Lassane was out there. I don't know if it was going to be overthrown him or not, but it looked like he got blocked up by one of the Raiders. So that might be huge, huge error for the Raiders if that is what I think it is. Well, there is a flag on the play, and it is under review right now by the referees. I mean, that really is the kind of error that the Raiders just, I mean, there's no need, and it wasn't necessary. But there's a mistake just, you know, holding down the C or the page down. But that just gives the Patriots a little bit of life, if that is what it's going to be called.
Maybe this is the advantage that they needed.
Well, they have a minute 53 left in the half, and it would be nice if they get at least one more score and bring it to a two-score game before the half.
Illegal
mic up. We're getting from Al. But Ahmed Hekroth did shout out pass interference. I'm not sure there's two flags in the play. Well, these delays here are kind of slowing down the game. I'm not sure exactly what. Because we have Alpinuka saying illegal mic up, Ahmed Hekroff saying pass interference.
Can there be two flags on a play?
Well, technically, but generally only one gets assessed. Usually the more severe penalty, unless they do cancel out. If it's against opposing teams, they will cancel out. Generally.
I just learned something new.
It depends on the severity of the foul, of the penalty. Excuse me. Foul is soccer. But I don't see any change on the field. It's still showing fourth down and 17, and Patriots are lining up.
I think it's still being discussed.
Oh, okay. Yeah, just saw everybody clicking on their pyramids there. I guess we're just goofing off. Well, whoever's on the stream right now, a little DMX. Oh, yeah. Or some mix of DMX. But if you guys are just tuning in, you missed a rather exciting first half. 1:53 left in this half. Start off with a beautiful, what was it, 61-yard pass to open up the game, first play of the game. So we've been seeing some deep, deep passes so far in this first game of season 2 of the CFL.
And we've been seeing so far the Raiders dominating over the Patriots.
Yeah, the Raiders have definitely found that just going to the left side, they're able to exploit that, and the Patriots, I don't think, have figured out how to get an answer for that. They might have to do some personnel changes, shift it up in the second half or even between plays and see what's going on here. Oh, here we go. We got
home team. 10-yard penalty.
Pass interference on the home team. Wow, so pass interference on the Patriots, not what they needed. I did see, I thought I saw pass interference, but wow. Not what they needed. Now it's 4th and 27.
They have no choice but to kick it.
They're going to have to punt it. I don't even know if there should be enough room to punt it, but yeah.
4th down.
There we go, balls in play, but no, they're lined up in that shotgun formation.
They are taking a huge risk.
Right, nope, there they go. They just switched the formation to the punt. They're gonna have to do it.
That was way too big of a risk.
Yeah. I thought on previous seasons, one tactic, I guess, for fourth down was to just send four receivers flying down and just air it out, and, you know, whoever catches it, catches it. But I don't think he has much room to do that. So he's going to definitely have to punt. 13 seconds left on the play clock. There he goes. And the punt goes kind of shanked to the right there. Out of bounds at their own, or the Patriots, 43-yard line. So great field position here for the Raiders. Less than half the field to work with.
I know last year, too, there was quite a bit of, on fourth down, lining up for the kick, but and then running the ball.
Right, but when it's fourth and 27, you're probably not going to run the ball. I really don't see them doing that, especially with how well the Raiders have been stopping that run. Marcus Saxon takes a snap, runs out to the right-hand side. He's got a couple receivers down there. No one in his face. He's looking right there. Action Jackson. Easy, easy for him. He's just dancing around a little bit. Not sure what the point of that was. Because the clock is still going. 1:33. Still plenty of time, really. Because that pass, 34-yard pass, brought them to the Patriots 9. So it's first and goal here for the Raiders. And there he goes, taking a snap, going out to the right. The left, which they've been exploiting all day, on his feet, and he does manage to get about 6 yards. So second and goal from the 3-yard line. Wow. I mean, I've not really been seeing the Patriots adjusting to that, trying to fix that issue they're having there on that left side, on that far side.
I agree.
There's a snap and a handoff to Valentino Fallon, who actually does get plugged up, so we spoke a little too soon. They came in, managed to get it to a 2-yard loss. So, 3rd and 5. And the visitors call a timeout, so the Raiders are calling a timeout there, stopping the clock with 29 seconds left. They really want to get that touchdown before we head off to halftime. That'll be a nice little exclamation point if they could if they can get in there. And I'm definitely
in
water.
If they get this touchdown before halftime, I don't see the Patriots coming back second half.
Well, there's Marcus Jacks. He's rolling out. He's got a couple guys out there. Throwing it, no, between receivers. I don't know if that was an error on his part or if someone was in the wrong spot, but there was just no one where he was thrown to. But yeah, no, you said it. I mean, 18 seconds left in this half. If it comes back in, they're going to be 4 scores down. And that's just tough to come back from, especially with how well these Raiders have been playing. There we go, same shotgun formation. And there's a snap. Marcus Jacks rolls out to the right. He's got a couple guys he's looking for in the end zone. But no, he's going to run it himself. He's out of the 3. Oh, brought down at about the 1 or 2-yard line. That was a turnover on downs. I did not realize it was fourth down, but a good job by the Patriots to keep the Raiders out of the end zone for halftime. I thought there should have been a little bit of time left on that, but I guess not. The Patriots at least kept it within 3 scores, 28-7. Raiders over the Patriots.
Club anyway, toys old lady, you say.
So I think we're having a great start so far.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
All my girls at the party, look at that body, shaking that thing like you never did see. Got a nice package, alright, cause I'm gonna have to ride it tonight. All my girls at the party, look at that body, shaking that thing like you never did see. Got a nice package, alright.
Edit.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Right, I think that's our halftime show there. Great job there by the Patriot Divas. Looking good in those jeans. Yeah. I kind of like them using jeans and little tank tops instead of traditional. outfits. Pretty cool there. Oh, wow. Well, I guess they're going to keep the players a little longer off the field. But your thoughts so far, Alex?
Yeah.
Or in other words, what do you think Patriots in specific are going to have to do?
I think they're going to have to tighten up their defense and do something with their offense if they plan on making any kind of a comeback in this game.
Yeah, that's certainly true. I mean, the Raiders have definitely found a couple weak spots in the Patriots' defense, and I think Patriots need to find that, need to find something that they can exploit, something they're good at doing to help them get some yards and get points on the board, of course. It's still within their reach. It's not, I don't think this game is completely out of reach yet. We still have, 18 minutes left of football, and they're only down by 3 touchdowns. So right, if they tighten up a little bit, if they, find a way of stopping those deep, deep passes the Raiders are putting up, and fixing that, their right side, the far side, excuse me, I think they could definitely get a little bit closer this game.
I agree, but if they allow any more touchdowns, it's over. And I think they're going to have to take that back to the field, and they're going to have to practice every day on working on that for their next game.
Right, and it is going to be a long season. So one game isn't going to be too big of a deal just yet. So as long as they could walk away from this, and at least knowing what pieces they need to fix, I think we'll definitely improve for the next game.
Perhaps it's taken them so long because he's regrouping right now.
Well, now here come the Raiders on the field. Just can't get enough. So let's see. I think we guess we're gonna roll with the same. I still have Mal Galaxy on the sidelines. Not coming in yet. And the Raiders right there already lined up, ready to go. Patriots a little, I don't know if they're hesitant to come out or they just weren't told to come out yet.
Radston is working on stuff. Oh, here they come.
Is that pasta saying getting something to eat? Yeah, probably. Oh, man. Well, for those of you joining us, this second half just about to start. 28-7. Raiders over the Patriot. So quite an exciting start, at least.
Welcome to the first game of Season 2 of the CFL.
Heaven is a place on earth. Nice song there. All right.
Wow, Miguel sings to everybody.
Go
ahead, Miguel. Carry on.
Whatever, I have the stream on, alright? I like the music. So still a little bit of issues there for the Patriots. Someone had, I guess, someone re-registering.
What are you supposed to be, some kind of a cosmonaut?
I just saw one of the Patriots leave. I'm not sure if they just crashed or what.
Perhaps that's the issue, that maybe some people had to go and they don't have enough players now?
This one, it looks like there's only 7 people in that locker room right now. Crip is on the outside, so they have 8. And they do seem to be coming out now. Whoa. So are they playing shorthanded now?
It looks that way, unless...
They're playing shorthanded. That's not going
to
make for...
Re-log.
Yeah, that's... I hope they're not playing shorthanded. That would not make for very... Very fun time for them. We got 5 on the field. Yeah, well, it's called ball and play. And the Patriots just do not seem to be ready.
Wow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I only see 6 on the field. We got Razin still out there. We got Don popping in. And Crip just kind of hanging out by the wall.
So they're not wasting any time.
I assume they're AFK. Pyramids aren't even up. The play clock is going down. 28 seconds left for the Patriots here to get themselves organized. We have Ahmed Hekroth out on the field right now. I'm not sure if they're going to stop the clock or... There's Razin coming out and... Don Ahadazuma. Which gives him, what, 8? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep, 8.
So, they're playing 1 man down?
I think so. Not sure if it's just temporary. Crip's just kind of hanging out there. Maybe he's AFK.
Wow.
And Don Hadazuma seems to be having some trouble there. He's just running off.
I thought that was only me saying
it's
that.
Just, we're running off. Lag issues, maybe? I'm not sure what's going on there. I know I had one instance in one of the preseason games where I ran off. Like, I just lagged out across the field and then ended up under the field. No way to get back up.
Wow.
Yeah, it was really, really weird.
I see somebody right now naked with a football helmet on.
I think that's what you want to see. Well, there's a kickoff. I don't know. Wow, and the Saint. I think there's some issue there. It says the Saint intercepted the ball, so I think they might need to re-register or something there. But it looks like the Patriots are going to be shorthanded and starting this off on their own 23-yard line. Let's see how Raston lines these guys up. Three, four, five. Yeah, I only see 7 right now.
Oh, because I'm seeing Don on the sidelines, and I'm seeing him without clothes on.
See, I see his clothes kind of over his body, so I don't know.
Okay.
I think that's just
well,
for you.
Well, it's good to know
a little,
that.
A little
that's
treat
just
for
me.
You.
Hopefully his clothes will resin quite soon.
In response to being shorthanded by 2, well, there's a flay, dead ball penalty, delay of game. So that's going to be 5 yards on the Patriots because They have not. They cannot seem to get themselves settled up here. It's but it seems
the
what they're going to do.
That's taping this does not see him naked. Because then it definitely is not no PG-13.
Well, Sports Illustrated put out the body issue just recently and has a bunch of athletes in the buff.
I don't know if you've seen that. It's been
interesting.
First down.
It could be tastefully done. All right, so let's see how they respond here. Looks like he's stacking the receivers on the far side with Diablo, Dark Matter on the same. Taking those spots, Pit Dog at wide receiver again. So he's going to leave himself quite open on the left, on the near side. 8:50 left in this quarter. So just underway for the second half, and thank you guys for joining us today. I am, of course, Miguel Devanter, and with me is Alex Xavier Heaney. And there's Razin taking the snap, rolling out to the right, looking for someone. He's going down. The Sane's out there, double covered, but manages to just enough to pick up the ball. Wow. Beautiful, beautiful strike there. 46 yards and the first down for the Patriots. So Razin's looking to... probably got his team fired up there. But Razin definitely looking to score regardless of being down two men. And looks like Crip Inglewood is back in there. Oh, he pulled off his running back out as a wide receiver spot. So we got Diablo, Dark Matter, Lassane, and Pit Dog all on the far side. Crip Inglewood by himself on the near side. Let's see what Razin does here. He takes a snap. He drops back. He's trying to look for... He got people in his face trying to look for a receiver. There he goes. Intercepted by Gucci Prada. Oh, and he slipped past the Patriots there. He's got blockers in front of him. He's down to the 40-yard line. About to cross the 50. Can he get there? He got tripped up a little bit, but no. Stays on his feet, and he is gone. 30, 20, 10, and touchdown Raiders off that interception. Wow. That was, what, a 90? And he caught the ball on the 3-4 yard line, so about a 97-yard interception return.
That was an amazing play. And sorry, Patriots, but I don't see you coming back.
I think that's Gucci's second interception this game. Wow. So here they go, Raiders lighting up for the point after attempt, and it is good. So 35-7 Raiders over the Patriots. It certainly is not looking good for them. It does not help that they were down two guys, or one that last play. I mean, it's still having one guy off is still detrimental. Still does bring down morale of the team sometimes, you know, especially when... It seems to me that Don had a zoom on the sidelines, just having a bit of lag issue. And that's just never good and always frustrating for any team dealing with that. So here the Raiders are lined up to kick the ball to the Patriots. And there it goes. Pit Dog fields it at about the end zone. But he's already at about the 20-yard line. He's got a bunch of white in front of him. And it is brought down about the 33-yard line. So a nice little run. Oh, 32-yard line, excuse me. So a nice run for the Patriots. Starting off at okay field position here. Still on their side, but... Oh, excuse me. So only one down, but Razin under center, Pit Dog back at running back, Diablo, Dark Matter, Lassane on the far side, Crip Inglewood on the near side.
The Patriots have a lot of work to do, but it doesn't help not having a full team either.
No, it doesn't, and there was a handoff there for no gain. Bree brings down Pit Dog. 3:18:05. What is her? Brianna. Brianna. There you go. All right. Wish people would use regular characters. All right, so Pit Dog has pulled off running back to wide receiver again. That three-man clump at the far side. It's just really, really hard for Razin here, being one man down. I mean, his line is just not able to keep up with the pressure. Because now the Raiders can send an extra man in pressure. You have Malik and Tarolf on him. And there's the pass. Deep, deep, deep. But, oh, picked off by Action Jackson, just waiting for it. It was a little overthrown from his intended receiver. And Action Jackson just happened to be right there. Didn't need to do much adjusting to pick that ball off. And brings it up to the Raiders' 46-yard lines. So 6:15 left in the quarter. 37 seconds left on the play clock. Plenty of time. Plenty of time. And the, I mean, really, the Raiders can slow it down. Just try to some running plays, which they've been very successful with so far. So I'm not sure if they're going to try to stick with that.
But it's very difficult when you have positions that need to be filled and you don't have the manpower to field them.
There's a little screen pass deep behind the line of scrimmage to Mal Galaxy, who manages to take it up, is dancing around the defenders, finally running in to Diablo Dark Matter, but not before he picks up 27 yards to the 19-yard line. So first and 10 for the Raiders at the Patriots' 19-yard line. So they're looking great right now. I mean, all they really have to do is control this ball, and he'll likely walk away with a W today. There's a snap. Marcus Jacks looking around. He wanted to throw the ball because he had an opening right in front of him, but he decided to throw it to Mal Galaxy, who does score 19 yards on that play.
Wow.
Easy, easy strike for him. 41-7. Now the Raiders just pouring it on here. It's really tough to see a team that does not have everybody out there. I think Donnie's back on the field finally.
Well, that's a plus in the Patriots' favor.
And the kick by Torolf Fenrisson is good. So 42-7 Raiders over the Patriots, 5 minutes and 5 seconds left in this quarter.
Do we have time
quarter.
For a sponsor?
You do have time for a sponsor. You can go right ahead.
Combatant is the first and still the leading innovator in high-quality, 100% original mesh and clothing products aimed for the football community within Second Life. We offer a wide range of products from cleats, helmets, compression, clothing, uniforms, hand warmers, gloves, and much more. Don't accept the cheap imitations determine the game, not the game determine you.
And combat gear is pretty good. Whoa, was that a fumble out into? Yep, out of bounds. So Lassane receives a kick, starts going up, but loses.
Referee, timeout.
Wait, that's kind of weird. So it's a fumble. Oh, okay, so Action Jackson recovers it, but I thought I saw the ball go out of bounds. Oh, yeah, he got tackled by Trayon. That's just a little weird. I'm not sure exactly what happened there, but referees did call a timeout to look it over. The referee laid them out. I'm not sure that that's in the rule book. But I'm sure it'll probably stand right there because I think he was going out. First down for the Patriots. They do have to flip possession there. Something's a little off. I'm sure the referees are going to fix it here. Then, yeah, combatant gear. I know I have a... Someone gave me some cleats from combatant. Pretty cool.
Oh, yeah? Nice
neon orange.
Good?
I like them. I like them. They're quite comfy.
Good.
But, I like the little neon orange design. Well, they're black with, like, neon orange accents. Very, very nice.
Oh, gosh.
And now I think they're helping out the Patriots a little bit, finding out what it was. So the ball now is on the 26, almost 27-yard line. So the Patriots have okay field position. They still seem to be a man. No, there we go. There's Red Magnifico. I guess he's going to be in the far side there with Diablo Dark Matter as wide receivers. Crip Englewood and the Saint on the near side now. So changing it up a little bit. Pit Dog still at running back and Razdin under center. And still going with that shotgun formation. I probably shouldn't even bother looking anymore. Because that's all they do. There's a snap, a handoff to Pit Dog. Going off to the left-hand side. He's got a few defenders there, but he's finding an angle away from them. And is brought down. But not before he picks up 11 yards and the first down. And that's the kind of thing the Raiders need to find. Or the Patriots, need to find. Is you know, plays like that where you get the first down. You know, establish some sort of run. You know, and kind of pick up a little bit of momentum here.
So they're doing a little bit better this after halftime than they did before.
Right, other than, you know, the moments where they were shorthanded. That never helps. So there's the snap, and again a handoff to Pit Dog. This time he goes right. He's got a little bit of open field, but no, Valentino Fallen. Valentino Fallen manages to sprint up to him and bring him down. But a flag is thrown on the play. And the referees are calling a timeout again.
False start.
And they're calling false start, so this play is going to come
home
back.
Home team.
Another penalty on the Patriots. This is not what they need.
I agree
with you. So, somebody jumped early. They're not saying who. I'm not being told who, so... it seems to me someone jumped early, probably off the line. field control is open. Oh, no. Oh, well, there we go. They're moving the ball back. Let's see. We're giving them 5 yards, 10 yards? 5. So 42-7, Raiders over Patriots. Patriots looking to get something going, but that false start really is not helping them. Here they come. I believe it's second down. No. It's like first down and 15. That's what the scoreboard is saying, but I thought it would be second down. Well, usually on a false start, it should come back. It should be a do-over. But there's a handoff. Pit Dog drops back, looking to throw. Throwing it deep, but picked off again by who? That's right, Action Jackson. Doing a great job there today receiving. I'll be kind of tired out there. Sprint not working and is brought down finally. So Patriots do, a good job. Keeping him out of the end zone there. But the Raiders are knocking down their door on the Patriots' 3-yard line. First down and goal.
I'm not sure. I just... I don't know what the Patriots are going to do now. I think they just need to tighten it up and find a way to get that ball down the field.
Yeah, I don't...
At least try and score one or two more touchdowns before this game is over.
There's a snap and a handoff. Oh, but he quickly brought down. I don't think. No, that was Tavani. Okay, that was to Valentino. So the Patriots managed to get in there and give them a little bit of a loss. 6 yards, actually. The Raiders did try to go to the left, which they've been having a lot of success with all night. There's a snap. Again, handoff to Valentino. He's going out to that left side. He's got blockers in front of him and wide open space. And there he goes. Just dances right in. 9 yards for the touchdown. 48-7 Raiders over Patriots. Sparta. It's calling Tarloff the best kicker in the league.
Well, we know who Pasta's fan is.
If you're considering so far this year, or this season, yes. Something happened there. The play was stopped. Referee's coming out to the field. Not sure what's happening there.
We've been seeing quite a bit of the refs on the field tonight.
Yeah, and it really isn't anything, you know, issues that I've seen before when originally started doing this many years ago. It's simply just, you know, actual rules, actual penalties being assessed and discussed. So always good.
So let's do another sponsor.
Go for it.
A&A has lots to offer from their home and garden, personalized gifts, frame shop, as well as their line of jewelry. Diamante, stop by today for that perfect gift for that perfect someone.
One more sponsor. Okay. We still got a lot of football left. Valentino Fallen actually kicked in that extra point. So 49-7 Raiders over the Patriots. 3:14 left in the quarter. So there's a lot of football left. And I really think it's just going to only pile on the Patriots from what I'm seeing. So
I agree that they've been completely dominated this entire game.
Yeah, and it gets frustrating. It gets really, really frustrating. I've been there. I know how it is when, you know, little things just don't come together. You have, you know, a line that isn't blocking enough, and it does get frustrating. And you know, I would not be surprised if there's a few unhappy people in the Patriots there. You know, the team speaks probably.
Well, like you've said before, the plus side is that it is the only first game of the season, and there is a whole lot of football to be played. So
it is true.
You can't count them out just yet.
You definitely can, and it's
everybody's gonna have at least one bad.
Of course.
Hopefully and this plenty, is the Patriots only one.
And plenty of time for the Patriots to improve on this. As we come down, 30 seconds left on the play clock for the Patriots. 3:04 left on the clock for this quarter. They're sticking with Usain and Red Magnifico in the far side, Crip and Diablo on the near side. Razin drops back. He's got 3-4 defenders chasing him, almost taking him out, but he does get the ball off. Oh, an action. Jackson almost there to pick it off again. I don't know. I think Carter Alchemy's absence here is probably hurting the Patriots a lot, too. I think
it's showing very much.
Yeah, I think they're definitely going to need Carter Alchemy to show up. So hopefully everything's okay with him in real life. I'm not sure what's keeping him off the field here. And okay. So Magnifico, I thought Magnifico was out in the sidelines, but he just popped over back to his spot there. So out of the shotgun here, Razin takes a snap, rolls back, kind of the right, four guys still rushing in, gets the ball up. Oh, Lassane somehow manages to pick it off. Four defenders around him. That pass was just threaded right into his hands.
Nice play.
It's a beautiful pickup, 28 yards, and that's the kind of things Patriots should just work on here. Just work on getting momentum, you know, and moving that ball down the line. So here they are out of the Raiders' 45-yard line. Two 13. Oh, the clock is ticking down. So 2:10 left on the clock for the quarter. And there's a snap. Razin takes it back. Same four guys in his face. Torolf being the closest to him. He does get the ball off. Picked off. This time Valentino Fallen picking it up. He's just running down parallel. I'm not sure. I guess he's like waiting for his blockers to come in. He's doing a great job dancing out to that near side there before he's finally brought down by Diablo Dark Matter at the Patriots' 38-yard line. So again, excellent field position. I mean, this is what, the third, fourth time that the Raiders have started in Patriots territory. Cool. So the Raiders have plenty of time here to just decide what they want to do, work that clock. And there's a snap. Marcus Jacks rolls out to the right. He's got some Patriots. Throws it. Throws a little screen pass out to Mal Galaxy, who throws it downfield. Nice little play there to Action Jackson for that touchdown. I'm not sure that pass was thrown forward or not. It looked to me like it was, but I do not see a flag on the play, so I guess it was a flat screen pass. not really what the Raiders need to be doing. I mean, that sort of play, it was great, it was beautiful, but they're up 55-7. Torolf here to kick up the point after attempt. I'm not sure that was a rather sportsmanlike call there by the Raiders to let that pass go.
It ends up happening every season. You get teams like that, so.
It does, and I understand making a statement, you know, first game of the season. I clearly understand that, but I believe the Raiders have already made that statement.
I agree.
56-7 now, minute 24 left in the third quarter. So we still have, you know, a whole other quarter to play. So, I don't know. So here we go. Let's see. Everyone seems to be ready and set. Let this out. Do not see the ball in play yet. Up there it goes. Kick is deep. Lassane Cook grabs it. Takes it up the side. He doesn't really have much. Now he finally gets to some of the Raiders. Dances around them for a little bit. I'm amazed he wasn't brought down sooner. But he does manage to get to the 29-yard line for the Patriots to start this next drive for them.
You have to give credit to the Patriots, too, for not giving up.
No, they're definitely not. And Razin is still airing the ball out, looking to get those hits, those long deep passes. Wow, I don't know why that was snapped. There was a Patriot not in place yet. Either way, a handoff to Pit Dog, but Malik Smitty there to bring him down. But Red Magnifico did not look like he was set and ready to go there. But he seems ready now, as Razdin and the Patriots line up in that shotgun formation that they've used all night. This time they move Diablo, Dark Matter, and Magnifico to the near side. Lassane and Crip out to the far. And we are 20 seconds away from the next quarter. But 10 seconds left on the play clock. There's a snap. Razdin runs out. Oh, that was just not needed there. That was brutal. He runs out.
Brutal.
And Tarulf was blocked. I believe that was Don who had him blocked. But he still managed to get his hands on Razdin and bring him down for that loss. And that does bring us to the end of the third quarter. So now we're in the fourth quarter. So a fresh 9 minutes on the clock. We're gonna take and I don't know what the delay is here.
I almost thought for a second there, Miguel, you were singing again.
I almost was, because, you know, it's Twisted Sister. And Razdin drops back. He's got three guys on him. Goes to the right, throws it down. He's got a couple receivers out there. Oh, wow. They kind of stopped and stood there, but Lassane Cook manages to bring it down. I did not see him grab it. I didn't know who grabbed it, actually. A lot of white was around him. So Lassane doing a great job adjusting and picking up all these yards through the air. Razdin doing an amazing job despite all the pressure he's having in his face by this, you know, Raiders defense just keeps rushing in. There's a snap. Razdin drops back, heading over to the left. The line actually picked up a few blocks there, so Razdin has some time to throw. He's throwing deep. He's got guys out there and picked up by Pit Dog. Great, great, great catch there. Another 30-yard play. It's another first down for the Patriots. So they're looking to speed it up here.
If trying only to get they those could strikes keep in. Those consecutively going.
Yeah, it most likely is a little too late for them at 7 minutes and 40 seconds left on the clock now. Man, Red Magnifico seems to be...
Late. This game, Red Magnifico, but, I mean, there's still a chance for them to get a couple of touchdowns.
Yeah. Definitely, and they better get set there. The Patriots taking a little bit of time setting in there, lining up. Now it's down to 7:17 on the clock, 10 seconds on the play clock. There's a snap and a handoff to Pit Dog, and Pit Dog is swarmed by Tarulf, right? Yeah, Tarulf there to bring him down for a loss of 4 yards. I think Razin's going to have to focus on throwing up in the air, but he seems to drop back a little too much. He needs to get a quicker strikes out. Especially with a shorter field that he has to work with now. There's a snap. He drops back, looking over to the right. He's got Diablo Dark Matter open out there in the corner, and there he goes right to him. Oh, just to his right, just out of reach. That brings up 3rd and 14 for the Patriots. So that was a good look there, but it was just out of Diablo's reach. But that did stop the clock for them, so 6:27 left. So out of the shotgun.
I think if they don't get anywhere have this someone, time, they need to just go for the kick.
The Patriots have someone out, but they're going to go with it. Razdin takes a snap, rolls back, going out to the left again. Malik hot on his tail there, but he gets the ball off, and he does have Pit Dog out there who just cannot adjust enough to well enough to get it. I think it was a little beyond his reach, a little overthrown, which it is kind of hard to throw when you got people in your face and people like looking to just bring you down.
Okay, just take the field goal.
At 4th and 14, yeah, at this point, I don't know. I'd probably be with Razdin here. I'd probably take this call. Just go for it. You know, if it's a turnover on downs, it's a turnover on downs.
I'd go for the points.
And there he goes. Takes a snap, goes back. Oh, he does catch the ball. Oh, no, it was intercepted. I don't know if it was over the line, but I guess not. So interception there, a touchback.
See?
So, well, I mean, either way, it's a little better. They were on the 22-yard line, so.
Well, yes, but if he would have just taken the points, then.
Right, but at this point of the game, he would need the touchdowns if, you know, to have a chance to catch up.
He doesn't have any chance to catch up.
Well, that's what I'm saying. You're not going to go. Although, unless you want to practice field goals, I guess.
Field goal would still give him 3 points.
Yeah, I guess. So Marcus hands the ball off to Valentino Fallen, who goes up to that left side that's just been Swiss cheese for the Raiders here. And he just tears through. He's running across the field to the left. A lot of blockers running with him. And there he goes, turns up between the numbers and the hash marks, and he is gone.
Yep, he's gone.
20-yard line, 10-yard line. Valentino Fallen running a little sideways, trying to bleed off a little time off that clock. Kind of nice of him, I guess, to do that. But a great 80-yard run for Valentino Fallen. 62-7, Raiders over the Patriots now. Wow. That's just not really what Patriots needed there, but I have a feeling there's some of their guys are just having some connection issues, it seems. Some of them running off the field. They are shorthanded right now. They've been shorthanded a few plays already. And Torolf kicks in that extra point, which is good. So 63-7 Raiders dominating the Patriots in this opening game.
Do we want to do our final sponsor for the evening?
Final sponsor. Let's go for it.
At Passionate Kisses, we offer interaction with others in a friendly and open environment. People who are looking for that one perfect Second Life sponsor to spend time with and see what Second Life adventures await them. Your Second Life single life will never be the same again. Speed dating parties, group outings, monthly events, game night.
Nice. I should sign up. So here we go. 4:50 left on the clock.
Oh my goodness.
Raz and the Patriots lining up in that shotgun formation. They are a man down.
Alike, apparently.
Red Magnifico on the far side of the Sane, and I think that was Crip, but a handoff to Pit Dog, who gets dropped for 5 yards loss. Excuse me, a 5 yard loss. So I really think Razin here is going to have to stick to the passing game, but definitely work on the running game after this. They're just not having much success running this ball. 4 minutes left in the game. 27 seconds on the play clock, and there's another handoff to Pit Dog. He's got a lot of white around him, and another loss, another 6 yard loss, 3rd and 21 for the Patriots. I don't know. I mean, are they listening at all? Stop running the ball. You know, I mean, really, Razin has had a lot of success passing. Are they 2 men down now? No. Diablo Darkmare is off my screen there. So Diablo Darkmare on the far side, Lassane and Red Magnifico on the far, excuse me, Diablo's on the near side. And Red and Lassane on the far side. Pit Dog still at running back. Razin takes a snap, runs out, but he's too much white around him. He does get the ball off, but way, way beyond his receiver. Gooch actually almost picked up his third or fourth. 4th and 21 here. This is not a good call either way. I mean, I do not agree with going for it, especially when you're a man down. I mean, if anything, pull a man off the line, put him at the other receiver spot, and send them all flying to the middle.
Maybe he's feeling as though he's just going to go for it all tonight.
I guess so.
Got nothing to lose.
So Diablo in red on the near side this time. Razin comes out left. He's looking for Lassane out there. Does get the ball off. Lassane does have two guys on him, but manages to catch it. Wow. So Razin and Lassane have had great, great chemistry here. And Lassane doing very well. Despite being double covered most of the night, just doing a fantastic job, especially when they need it the most, like right there.
That was a
really
very good play by Raston.
Amazing, amazing play. So I guess it paid off, that gamble. A 2-minute warning, but the clock is still going. There's a snap. Razin looking over to the right, but handed off to Crip Inglewood, who gets dropped down for a loss of 3. I don't know if that handoff was intentional or not. It looked like Razin was just going to run himself. And I think Crip was a lineman, was he?
I believe so.
Oh, so there might be a flag on that play. Oh, no, Crip is lining up on the... I think they're trying to get away with something there, but... I'm not entirely certain. But now Crip is out as wide receiver, but Pit Dog gets the ball, running up the right. Manages to pick up a few yards, but steps out of bounds after 6. Bringing him to the Patriots' 43-yard line. But the clock is still running. That's why I should have stopped with him stepping out of bounds. But it hasn't. 45 seconds left. 40 left on the play clock, so really not much here. Not much time left, excuse me, for Razdan to do. I don't know if I was the Patriots. I would just look for a deep score real quick. And time is not his friend right now. There's a snap. Razin dropping back. He's got Malik and Brianna right on his tail. He does get the ball off. Got several guys out there, but overthrows them. That should have stopped the clock. I'm not sure why it's not stopping. Is that 8-7? There's something wrong with that clock. The clock should have been off. Should have turned off when Pit Dog ran out of bounds. And should have gone off there with that missed pass. I guess just let it go. Oh, the mercy rule. That's right. Thank you, Rico, for reminding me about that. I totally forgot. I don't like mercy rules. But totally forgot about that rule. But yeah. Forgot about that. I don't know if I like that much, but there you go. First game of the second season for the CFL comes to a close with lopsided 63-7 Raiders over the Patriots. I don't know. Any final thoughts there, Alex?
This has been quite a first game. I think the Patriots know where their weaknesses are, and the only thing they can do now is just work on them for the next game.
No, that's certainly true. They definitely need to work on their running game. But I think before that, they have to tighten up their defense. They have to work on that, you know, either zone coverage or which I think works better in this in Second Life football. But they've just been exploited, particularly that right side of theirs. The Raiders just running up and down it all day long, and the Raiders just were very good defensively as well, picking off the ball, what, 5 times? I mean, that's just a lot of turnovers. I mean, you're not going to win with that many turnovers. That's just not going to happen.
Who are we playing tomorrow?
Tomorrow? I'm actually unsure of the schedule. I know I'll be here on Saturday night.
I believe we have the Panthers and
the Panthers,
Eagles.
You're right.
Yes,
the Panthers and
Al.
The Eagles coming out. There you go. So thank you guys for joining us tonight for this game, and do either tune in tomorrow or get a ticket and come out here to see the Panthers and the Eagles. The Panthers,
the
of course.
Came out to watch. We appreciate you guys.
Panthers are the rebranded Spartans who won last year, won the CFL Bowl last year. Just playing under a different name and some slight personnel changes. So
I
always
hope you
a good.
All have a great night. Because I have a feeling Miguel's gonna sit here talking all night about the Panthers.
I'm like, yeah, well, you know, I watched them all last.